All right, you've had your fun, but leave Kelly to us, and that's a final warning.
Look, I'm only talking about giving them a fright. You stop the girls getting it out of their system, you might find them wanting to take more direct measures, like killing her.
Fair enough, but don't go too far.
Very nice. Just what we wanted.
Yeah, that's what I was afraid of. I'll see you later.
Thanks, love.
Can I have a look now?
Oh, don't worry. After the first couple, you won't even know what you're drinking.
Ferguson's coming. Call the bugger.
About a bloody drac.
I've got some more running about to do. You'll be okay until I get back?
No way I'm answering the door looking like this.
Yeah, well, just make sure that dog doesn't bite.
Hey, what have you done to your hair?
Oh, this is nothing. I used to look like Boy George when I first went to Wentworth.
Yeah. I thought I read about him having an image change. Started looking like a man at last. Well, when you get overseas, you can look like Carmen Miranda if you like, but I think the ribbons should go. Look, I shouldn't be away long. Just remember, don't answer the door to anyone.
Oh, no worries. Look, are you sure you can trust this guy who's doing the passport photos?
Oh, Giuseppe's an old mate from way back. Oh, God, still no answer. Oh, I think I'll be quicker to hail one. See you later.
Yeah, bye.
Just give us a hoy if you see one of the screws coming.
What do I get out of it?
A thick ear if you don't do it. This party's just for the girls that hung out in the ride, okay?
It's not fair.
Well, I tell you what, you do the job well enough, I might even give you a sack of
What is it?
It's whiskey, the best. So just keep your eye on it.
It's party time!
It's a really awful taste.
Oh, who cares about a bit of rubber as long as it gets you Molly?
Pardon?
Molly the monk.
Drunk.
What you are!
Oh.
Hey, I tell you what we need. We need a war cry.
What?
For the gang, the Wentworth Warriors. We all got to have one. Hey, what about Warriors?
I couldn't do that.
Of course you could.
I couldn't.
Of course you're bloody good. Warriors!
Did I do it right?
Music to my ears, sister. Hey, why don't you give us another one? Do it for Jules.
All right.
Warriors! Fantastic! I told you you were Molly.
Oh, no, I couldn't be.
Lozano, come here.
You, Miss Ferguson?
I said come here. Now, come on, the men doing the security grill have left a mess in the laundry. Get down and clean it up. On the double.
Ferguson? Can you take over reception for a while? Ratcliffe's feeling a bit off colour.
I'm just about to check on that racket.
I'd rather they were laughing than fighting. Now, come on. Ratcliffe's on her last legs. I think it's that virus Meg had.
Oh, come on, Poco. Where the bloody hell are you?
I know you're at home, you old devil. Just heard you got out today. Got some flowers for you. Oh, come on, Jess had to travel all this way by bus to get here. Have room with you. Have you got another bloke in there?
She's not home.
Well, who are you then?
Friend. We'll come back tomorrow. She'll be here then.
Oh, fair enough. Just tell her Harry called, will you? Got some flowers here. All right if I leave them. They won't last until tomorrow.
Okay, look, leave them on the doorstep. I'll pick them up in a minute.
Okay. I'll see you later then. Sentence you, you go into prisons that are more like bloody holiday camps. Half of you escape at the drop of a hat. Oh, shut up that bloody dog before I skewer it.
Shut up, Bogart, it'll be all right. Listen, mate, look, you got the wrong person. I'm just a friend of Jesse's, I'm no crim. Come on, please, please believe me, eh?
I spent a lot of time and sweat catching crims like you, Patterson. I don't like to see you getting away.
Jess, back from holidays?
Yeah, that's right, dear.
You don't look too brown. Mabel said you went to Hawaii.
Yes, I did. Stayed inside a lot, though.
Oh, bad weather, eh?
Pretty stormy. Yeah. Things haven't changed around here. Can't hail a cab for love nor money. Have to do it on the phone again. Aloha, Doris.
Maybe you should have stayed inside. Maybe when they know what's happened to you and Flynn or those other bitches, I'll think twice before going over the wall. Because they know I'm out here waiting for them. I thought you'd agree. Then you won't be here to see them, will you?
Kill him, that's what he deserves.
Well, I know he's a murderer, but you can't just kill him in cold blood. Bessinger. Harry Bessinger. Name rings a bell.
Well, look, we can't hand him into the cops. If we do, I'm gone. We've got to get rid of him somehow. Don't you have mates who can do it?
Bessinger. Why does that name seem so familiar?
Game, set, and match. Oh, geez, you lot can put it away.
Oh, don't look at me. I reckon I only have one and a bit.
Well, what happened to the rest of the bit?
You already drank it.
Yeah?
Well, there must be more blood than I thought.
You know, I used to be able to drink the conquerors under the table. Even Slasher.
Oh, geez, I'm a thoughtless bitch. I didn't even drink to him. Here's to you, mate. Wherever you are.
You really loved him, didn't you?
Yeah, I sure did. There were heaps of others before him, but no one could touch Slasher.
Well, I've had my toast. It's your turn now, Ned.
Oh, no, I've got nothing
to
toast.
No, no, really. Go on.
Oh, all right. Here's to new friends. Oh. And to my baby, Peter. I always call him my baby, though he's taller than I am, but that's Mum's for you.
To your baby. Good on you, Lance.
Well, here's to my mum. She's dead, but I think about her a lot.
Okay, come on, you two. It's your turn now.
No more downers.
This is a party, not a wake.
An indoor tennis tournament, is it? With whiskey chasers?
Where the hell did you come from?
Just passing. You're running a bit of a risk, aren't you?
Bloody Gina.
Who?
Gina, I put her on net. I'm going to knock her bloody block off.
Oh, it's none of my business if you get your kicks sucking on tennis balls.
You're all right, you know that?
Oh, I reckon you deserve it after the riot. But I'd put somebody else on net if I was you.
Yeah, okay. Well, we finished anyway. Would you mind keeping your eye out?
Okie dokie.
Come on, chomp on a bit of toothpaste to kill the breath. We don't want the screw smelling it on you.
Are you okay?
Yep. Just a little bit tipsy.
A little bit? Do you think you could manage a few words with me?
Gosh, he could manage a few words. Go to it, Chucky.
Doctor. That's your story.
Hurry up, don't keep running me, I'm waiting.
He's not a bad bloke for a wimp.
Come on, girls, let's get this place cleaned up.
Why do you call him a wimp?
Well, he has to be a wimp if he does one of them centrefold things.
Mind you, he's got his good points.
But then again, as an Eddie bloke...
You really shouldn't be drinking after confession. You sure you're okay?
Yeah, thanks for worrying.
Oh, before, I heard you mention your mother.
Yeah, that's how come I'm in here. I stole some money to make her last couple of months a bit happier.
Look, you don't owe me any explanation.
No, it's okay. I found out she was dying. I wanted to do something. We were pretty poor after my dad walked out.
So what did you do with the money?
Send her on a round-the-world cruise. She wanted to see Italy most of all. She reckoned it was twice as good as she pictured.
You really loved her, didn't you?
Yeah. Wish I could have done more. I don't want you to think I'm making excuses or anything. I mean, I know what I did was wrong.
And you've paid for it. I mean, once you get out of here, that's it. You start afresh.
Hope so. How many people want to know about an ex-crim?
Some do. Believe me. I better get back to work. Mr. Moran will give me another ticking off. And you're meant to be on guard, aren't you?
Yeah.
We'll talk again, though, eh?
No, no, there's no girl like that around here.
She's got a dog, ruddy little thing, light brown terrier.
Oh, yes, I think I can help you there. My husband saw it earlier running out of Jessie's. Come to mention it, there was a girl running after it. I didn't see it myself. Hey, Bert?
You keep still or I'll smash another bloody bell through me head.
Calm down, girl. Oh, come on, come on.
Do you reckon they'll do it? It'll cost, but they'll do it. They're professionals. Not that you deserve it, Buster. It'll be a quicker death than you gave Nora Flynn. Oh, I still wish there was some other way, though.
Oh, he's a bloody madman. Probably be doing the world a favour.
That's not the point. I mean, we're talking about a setting someone up to... Hell, check that out. It's the cops. Oh. I couldn't have done it anyhow.
What do you mean?
Well, having him bumped off makes us as bad as he is. Best just to hand him over to the cops. Quick, run out the back and go for it. Go back to the brothel. They'll look after you.
Yeah, but what about you?
I'll be all right, okay. Here. I'll get in touch with you as soon as I can.
Oh, you're great, Jess.
Time you copped it, Buster.
There's another one poking around at the back.
Oh, hell, just when we want the police.
Yeah, well, what are we going to do?
Oh, I don't know. The jig's up there. There's no way we can hand him over and keep you safe.
Mr. Freeland, come and open up. It's a routine inquiry.
No, that's what you think. Coming. Oh, I don't know. There's nothing we can do, love. We're snooker.
Look, I can't handle going back to Wentworth, and I'll put you there too for helping me.
Well, them's the breaks, love. But you'll be a hero for stopping a madman in his tracks.
Your note was told.
Okay, officer, the kid's here. We got another bundle for you, too.
He just tried to kill Lexie.
I walked in on it. His name's Bassinger, Harry Bassinger.
Oh, don't untie him. He's a bloody loony. Look, that's a knife he was going to use. He's the one that killed Nora Flynn.
You chose the wrong victim, young lady.
What are you doing here, Superintendent? What's going on?
Superintendent? Harry Bassinger, why didn't
you... You mean he's a bloody cop?
Ex-cop, one of the top brass. Officer, I know how this must look to you, but we're telling the truth.
Yeah.
He came in here threatening to kill Lexie.
Just keep an eye on them, son. I'll explain everything.
You should be home in bed, Harry. That head looks nasty.
Thanks for the compliment.
You know what I mean. There's no need for you to even be here. We'll look after them now.
I'll hang around till they're charged. Don't want them slipping through my fingers at this stage.
Come on, Harry. No one's going to believe them.
You might have if it had been anyone else but me. The kid's clever. It has to be coming up with that maniac thing as a cover.
The only thing you did wrong was to go in for a citizen's arrest when you should have called us. Sounds to me like you're missing the old days.
I tell you what, retirement's a bugger. Too much time to think what you did and no chance to do anything. When I saw the kid, I thought, get in there, Harry. Even picking up a small-time escapee from a women's prison is better than nothing. Famous last words.
You must be rusty to let her get the drop on you.
Well, so would you be if you'd spent the last 2 years at home looking after the garden. I tell you, it gets to you.
Yeah, well, no harm done.
I hope not. But there's still my fingerprints on that knife. I want forensic to do the works on it. I want everything done by the book.
Go home and leave it to us to sort out. You've got nothing to worry about. They'll both get what's coming to them.
Yeah, fair enough.
But, Horace, you've known me long enough to know I wouldn't be lying.
You said yourself you didn't actually see Bassinger with the knife. For heaven's sake, Harry Bassinger.
Mr. Crean himself.
But I don't care.
Bassinger's had more awards and citations for bravery than the entire
police force put together. Half the state's politicians turned out for his retirement dinner.
But that's not the point.
I was there myself. He's highly respected. No court's going to take your word against his.
Would you?
As a judge? No.
Frankly, I think you've let the kid pull the wool over.
Horace, we've known each other for 20 years, and I've never asked you for a favour, but this time I swear I need one. I know Lexie's telling the truth.
I'm sorry, Jess. There's nothing I can do. Apart from anything else, I can't have my name associated with the next madam.
Not in a case like this. I'm sorry.
One more?
I'd patent this if I were you. It was delicious. Superb.
To be quite honest, one Mervyn taught me. The cook at Wentworth.
Well, it sure beats the tin pears and cream I had planned for tonight. Maybe that's why Bongo and Roach hightailed it.
Oh, wish it was. Fred, I bombed out rather badly, didn't I?
No. And no more soul searching, remember? Not till tomorrow, anyway. Thanks for a lovely meal.
Glad you stayed. I needed the company.
Well, you know what they say about us men of God. Sensitive to the core. You still miss Wentworth, don't you? I'm just curious. You're just obviously not the type who can walk away from something easily.
Yes, I do. You saw how I was when I heard about the riot. Thought I should be there. It's illogical, I know, but I still felt it.
Do you think you might go back?
If you'd asked me that on the day I left, I'd have given you a categorical no. No, I'm not so sure. When I think back on it, it seems, I don't know. I was pretty low on energy at the time, and then May Collins' death coming on top of it. Frankly, I was in no fit state to run a prison.
What?
Nothing.
No, what?
I hadn't even admitted that to myself, let alone anyone else. You men of God aren't only sensitive, you're Dorothy Dix, Dear Abby, and Father Confessor all in one.
Well, you've got to admit, for a bikey, that's not bad.
Oh, no! I'll never get the hang of this. I keep missing the ball.
You're more tank than I thought you were. Come on, try another go, Nance. This time I have a foot the other side to make up for the tennis juice.
Tennis juice!
You're going to be a bunch of hangover warriors in the morning, aren't you? Okay, Nance, give it another go.
Oh, no!
Something you want to talk about? No, nothing special. Why?
Seems to be a lot of whispering going on over here.
I thought I heard Gina's name too. Well, you didn't have to thump her. I put her on knit. She didn't do her job.
She got dragged off by the freak.
So she should have warned us. You know what your problem is, Maggot? You're just crapped off you didn't get any grog. Will you show me you're not still one of Kelly's scumbags, and the next time you might. The same goes for the rest of you. Kelly is finished. Kaput. If I find any of you still backing her, I'll come down on you like a rickety dunny in a hurricane.
I'll call Etty in the morning, find out how Roaches might even pop over there.
Well, on a Sunday, go on. Take the day off.
Well, I don't want the girl to feel that I hold it against her going off with Bongo.
I'll give that boy a kick in the bum, believe me. Not that it'll do any good. You'll probably just kick back.
Don't cause yourself any trouble.
I'm used to it. Anyway, look, forget all that. And get yourself a good night's sleep and thanks again for the meal.
I'm sorry.
No, I'm sorry. I've just got my signals crossed, that's all. Good night.
Look, what happened to me dog? They said they'd find out what happened to me dog for me.
I'd say your dog would be the least of your worries. Wait here.
Bastard. He's right, you know.
What do you mean?
Well, about her being the least of our worries. I've tried everyone who could help. Not a soul believes us. Not a soul. Bessinger's too bloody clean.
Oh, we got the knife and the fingerprints.
Yeah. Yours are on it too. And he's saying we wrapped his hand round the knife while he was unconscious.
That lying bastard!
I hate to say it, kiddo, but we're up the creek without a paddle. And that maniac's going to be let loose to try it again.
Waiting for you.
Oh, I only just had breakfast, Miss Ferguson.
Go on. I'm waiting over there. Come on, Kelly, against the wall. Well, how the mighty have fallen. By the way, your mates Donnelly and Stone have been bundled off to D Block, but the governor decided to leave you here under our protection for your own good.
Bitch. You talked him into it, didn't you?
Nice try, Kelly. But you know, there aren't enough charges in the book to keep you in the pound. Now, you're gonna get out of here if I have to drag you out by the ear. Move!
What are they doing with you?
What do you reckon? Same as you. I'd feel safe if I was being tossed into a bloody snake pit.
Well, come along, ladies. We don't want to keep that welcoming committee waiting, do we?
No, I don't think my stomach's in the mood.
Mine either.
How are the party girls this morning? Showers freshen you up?
Oh, I feel as if I've got tennis balls bouncing around in my head. I think mine have turned into cricket balls.
Hey, I'll tell you something. She was snoring her head off last night. It must have been the booze.
Oh, I couldn't have been. I've never snored in my life.
I bet you've never been that blotto either.
Oh, you know, I don't think I'll ever enjoy watching Wimbledon again.
Not too keen on the scotch, eh?
Oh,
no. Oh, rubber. Oh. Better on the road than in your gut. Maybe bourbon next time, eh?
Maybe we'll smoke.
Come on, girls, eat up. The best way to get rid of a hangover is to bury it.
Would you like mine?
I don't think I'll bother either.
Well, suit yourself. Hey, guess who's getting out of the pound this morning?
Lou and Lurch.
I reckon I might take time off to have a little chat to him.
Make sure they understand the new ground rules. Think I might go to the chapel service. What time do you say it started?
10.
You sure you want to go? He's really boring.
Oh, well, it's the act of worship that's important, not who conducts.
You won't find me singing no hymn, sister. I got a voice like a busted muffler.
Oh, you know, I feel a bit guilty going to church with a hangover.
Hey, listen. Girls were complaining last night about the lack of hooch. I've been thinking, if we were bottling our own, we'd be sweet. We'd have it on tap. Rage whenever we like.
I mean, have a still.
There's more than one way to skin a cat with your hair on and off.
It's a bit risky. I mean, Lou's going to want to get back at you any way she can.
Oh, don't worry about her. She'll be quiet as a dormouse.
I hope so.
Oh, Julie!
Oh, get out! Oh.
Hello.
Bob, it's Kath Maxwell. I'm sorry, did I wake you?
No, that's all right. I was up already. They want me in at Wentworth. What can I do for you?
Oh, nothing. I mean, you'll be too busy. It doesn't really matter.
You didn't call me this hour on a Sunday morning to tell me that.
I know. I can't think straight, Bob. I don't know what to do.
Where are you? You sound like you're in a phone booth.
I'm at the hospital.
What about Alan? Is he there?
No, he's away on business again.
Well, I'll see you in a few minutes.
Look, I don't want to be a nuisance.
It's no problem. You just get into your car and come straight over, okay?
I will, and thanks.
Now, with all the heat and vapour, the pressure here'd be critical. We'd have to keep a really close eye on it in case it got too much.
So no wonder Mad Dog's shed blew up. We need a bloody scrap metal yard to make one of them. Perhaps we should stick to the simple stuff.
I've seen where Merv keeps the yeast.
And there'll be no problem smuggling out some fruit juice and sugar. We'll really put this place on the map. Best plonk in town.
Trouble's going to be finding somewhere to hide it long enough for it to ferment.
It must be somewhere. Maybe some old shampoo bottles or
hey,
something.
Hey, wait a minute. Those detergent tins in the laundry, we could scrub them out and put in there.
Nice one, Professor. You just earned yourself the next hangover.
I don't think I'll ever get over this one.
Oh, morning, ladies. How are we this morning?
Real good, Mrs. Barry.
Oh, Julie, you're looking a bit pale. Are you sure you're feeling all right? You don't want to see sister?
No, I'm fine, really.
Oh, all right. I'll be on my way then.
Oh, Mrs. B, rat-faced and ugly out of the pound, yeah?
If you mean Kelly and Jenkins, yes, but I don't want any trouble from you.
I just want to say g'day to them, that's all. I haven't seen you for a while.
As long as that is all.
Now, I wonder where them two can be hiding. They can't be in their cells. You would have seen them on the way.
Yeah, that'd be right.
What?
Follow me, sister. We got some praying to do.
All things bright and beautiful, all creatures great and small, all things wise and wonderful.
Oh, just shut up. I'll get Nick to know this one. We used to sing it on the farm. Shut up. I hope we figure out how to keep them calling us off our back or not.
It seems the good Lord has seen fit to bless me with a head cold at this time, but I must and I will carry on. Lord, thou hast been a dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth forever, thou hast formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting.
We can't keep hiding now. What? We need time to think. We're not walking back in there and copping a sweep from that monk. Which one is that, Lou?
When you're ready. Bless thee, sinners, Lord.
Let them come and come and pray for Eve one. How about you? While you're here, why don't you get him to read you your last rites? You never know when you might need him.
Amen.
Special Sunday delivery for you.
Oh, yeah. I heard they'd been picked up.
Yeah, well, you're welcome to them. They get both to us from cooling off, I can tell you.
Looks like they'll have plenty of time for that. Yeah. Assault with intent to cause grievous bodily harm. Assault occasioning actual bodily harm. You've been quite busy, haven't you, Patterson?
Don't you bloody start.
Now, you're in quite enough trouble as it is. Don't add to it. I didn't think we'd lose you for too long, Wyndham. See, the trouble with the department is they let their emotions cloud their judgment.
No chance of that happening with you, is there, Miss Ferguson? Now, if you wouldn't mind getting on with it.
Come on in and sit down. Just relax. Sorry about the mess. Bachelor's quarters.
I should be the one apologising to you barging in like this.
Kath, we've known one another too long for any of that nonsense. Had a bad night, eh?
Bad night, bad week. It's been so bad for so long, I just had to talk to somebody.
And Alan's still away.
Yeah, well, that's okay. It's almost easier without him. Bloody Vietnam destroyed him too.
Well, none of us knew how bad it was going to be when we first got out there.
How could you? No one knew about antifoliants then. Look, I know it's not Alan's fault that he can't cope with pressure, and I know he's in pain most of the time. But so is our daughter, and she's only 5, Bob. She can't even tell me. I just see it in her eyes. God, I feel so helpless.
Beth, I wish there was some way I could make things easier for you.
There's nothing anyone can do. Nothing.
checked in this morning, I knew she was worse. And I knew there really wasn't anything more they could do for her.
Would you like me to come to the hospital with you now? We'll talk to a doctor.
I did this morning. Look, Bob, I know they're doing all they can for her, but it is just not enough.
They'll find something that does work.
For a while, maybe, and then this whole awful cycle will start again. What sort of life is that for my little girl? I can't bear it, Bob. She's in so much pain. Why can't they just let her die?
Stop it, Kath. You don't mean that.
I do. What right have we to prolong this hell she's going through?
Now, just a minute. You're giving Linda everything she needs, your love and the best medical care available. You can't do more than that, so stop torturing yourself.
See what you meant about the services here. Apart from anything else, the poor man looked dead on his feet.
Oh, I reckon Dan the man could talk rings around that bloke. He's got a feel for where the people are, you know? What's hassling them?
I wonder if Alice and Lou picked anything up.
Well, if they did, they didn't stick around to talk about it. They took off faster than a Harley on a drag strip.
Got a surprise for you.
Bloody hell, what are you doing?
Hi, girls. Afraid we blew it.
What happened?
Hey, Patterson, don't leave out the bit about the maniac, eh? Nice touch of colour, that.
It bloody happened, I tell you.
What happened? What's she talking about?
I'll tell you later. Wish I could say it was good to be back.
Cut it out, will you? You're driving me up the bloody wall.
Oh, jeez. I'm more nervous staying out of sight than facing the bitch. Well, what are we going to do, Lou?
I'm thinking. All right.
Well, how long's this thinking going on for? Well, we've got to front them sooner or later. Maybe we could get Ronnie and Jacko to have a talk with Connors. Cool her off a bit.
Them bitches, they're sucking up to her like all the rest. I'm wasting our breath.
Well, what are we going to do?
We front them. We tough it out.
You sure? Geez, what if...
It was your bloody idea in the first place. Look, if we look like we're scared, they're going to jump us. So we show them that we're not going to take none of it. And then we've got a show.
It might make any difference. Not after what she said in the chapel.
Well, have you got any better ideas?
Suppose not.
Right, then let's go.
Well, thank God the taxi didn't stop when I hailed it.
And you didn't see Bassinger's car parked outside?
No, I was so worried about Lexie's papers organising them, I didn't even look. Come on, love, you wear the spots off those.
Stuff it, I don't want to play any.
Hey, we got a gang going here.
No one's expecting you to be jumping for joy about getting back in here, but try and keep a lid on it, okay?
I was so close, and then I'd be a bloody psycho like Bassinger.
Tough break.
Yeah. I mean, he'll get another tin star, and I'll end up in here for good. Great, eh?
You ain't the first, and you certainly won't be the last.
And that's supposed to make me feel better?
It's supposed to make you feel less angry towards everybody, including us.
It's all Kelly's bloody fault. I mean, if she hadn't been after me, I wouldn't have gone through with it.
Well, we're here now, and that's that. Maybe Moran can do something for us. He's an upfront sort of guy.
Whoa, 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 take it easy.
Well, fancy seeing you here. Like the haircut. Where'd you get it, Paris?
Oh, you bitch, I'm bloody well
sick. Get her out of here, get her a cold shower or something.
I'm gonna get you if it's the last thing I do.
My bloody fault the wimp got picked up.
You got a big mouth, Kelly. But you get one of these stuck in your gob, they're gonna have to bust your jaw open to get it out.
Yeah, you tried. You have a war on your hands. Right, Lurch?
I don't see her trying to stop me. Or anyone else, for that matter. Any takers? Looks like you two are on your lumps. Oh, and don't leave town. I've got a couple of special events I'd like you to hang around for.
I'm not bloody killing. I'm going to have a crack at killing if it's the last thing I do. Not just for what she did to me, but what she did to you, too.
Lexie, calm down. Now, Rita says what goes from now on. She doesn't want anybody to make a move on their own.
Yeah, yeah, you're right. Mister got me old bed back.
And me also,
Mary. Yeah. I know it sounds selfish, but I'm glad you're back. I really missed you.
Oh, jeez, Chook. Fancy missing a stupid bugger like me.
Oh, still hurts, eh?
Oh, just a bit. It's not as bad as it was. Hey, we're an odd-looking couple, aren't we? Man, with no makeup in this hair.
Oh, I've kept your makeup. I hid it in case anyone tried to rip it off.
Yeah? You beauty, Chook.
Pepe, what's it like being outside?
Well, I couldn't go anywhere, so it was sort of like being in here. Gee, it was good to see new faces, though. Mitzi and Dolores was great. Even Mabel was okay. But Poco was the best. Crazy little mutt.
Poco?
Yeah, some sort of little mongrel. Picked me up my first day out, a terrier or something. Wouldn't leave me alone. Gee, she was a happy little dog. Don't know why I had to start talking about her, eh?
Look, here's your makeup. That'll cheer you up, hey? Lexie?
Yeah?
I was wondering if you could give me some advice.
Yeah, sure. What is it?
Well, you have to promise not to tease me.
Promise? What is it?
I think I'm in love.
I'm sorry, Bob. You've got so much on your own plate without me adding to it.
I wish I could offer something more concrete than just words.
Very helpful words, believe me.
I hope you weren't serious, Kath, talking about letting Linda die.
No, I suppose not. It's just that sometimes it gets so hard to tell what's right and wrong. It all seems so subjective.
If it's a choice between life and death, there really isn't.
Thanks for reminding me.
Sure, I can't offer you a coffee.
Oh, no, look, I'd better be going. I've made you late enough as it is.
If I remember right, the last time we went walking, we were 10 and running away from home.
We got as far as the bus stop.
I thought you had the money.
I did.
Enough for ice creams anyway.
Thanks again.
Anytime.
You're very special, Bob.
I told you you'd feel better.
Yeah, still can't cop the hair, bud.
Hey, maybe you could borrow Mrs. B's wig.
Look, stop changing the subject. Tell me what happened with you and Steve.
Well, ever since he first came here, I thought he was really nice.
Look, I know that you do.
But I used to get real embarrassed the way the other girls
carried
on.
Look, I know that too. Get on with the interesting bit.
And you said you wouldn't tease.
No, I just want to know what happened.
Well, after you went over the wall, we had a couple of really good talks, and I wasn't shy or anything. We seemed to have this rapport.
What's that?
Oh, well, it means, you know, we've got an understanding.
Already? Jeez, Chuck, you're a fast worker.
Not that sort of understanding. It means that we, you know, we understand one another's point of view.
Right.
And Sister Hall said he was terrific during the rite, saved my life, no worries.
Don't know what you want my advice for. You seem to be doing pretty well on your own.
Just a bit scared. I mean, what hope have I got with a guy like Steve? He's a doctor. I'm a crim.
Chucky, you stop right there. Your parole's coming up and you're going to get it. Once you're on the outside, you won't be a criminal anymore.
Oh, I hope you're right. Oh,
of course I am. On top of it, you've got brains and you're pretty. Look, if he's going out of his way to talk to you, he's got to like you. Because you're never going to look plainer than you do now if you live to be 100.
Hey, I just had a word with Mrs. Barry. She's arranged for us to see the governor as soon as he gets here.
Oh, should be in a good mood coming in on his day off.
Don't you want to stop that animal?
Look, why should he give us stuff? It's not his problem.
Oh, he seems like an honest man. He might want to help.
Yeah, well, I'm damn well going to give it a try.
Hey, Lex, if you're finished putting on your wall paint, we got things to do.
What's up?
Here, read this.
What is it?
It's a charge sheet. The people versus Kelly and Jenkins. And you're prosecuting.
When you're finished with the primping...
Oh, sorry, Miss Ferguson. Sundays are always so quiet before the visitors arrive.
Yeah. Listen, one of the toilets in D block's backing up. You'd better call an outside plumber. We won't get anything done through channels till Monday.
Oh, fine. Oh, quicker still, why don't I give Steve Ryan a call and see if he can pop
do what you like. I'm going to take me break.
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
I'm not telling you. Shut up.
That's not what she said.
That's what she meant. Now shut up.
You are also charged with attempted murder of Lexie Patterson.
Yeah, you bitch.
And inflicting grievous bodily harm on Rita Connors and me. How do you plead?
I'm not pleading nothing. Come on, Lurch, I'm taking this crap. You're not going anywhere, Princess. You've got a few debts to pay.
I don't owe nobody nothing. Now get your paws off me.
You or Jenkins leave this room, you're as good as dead. Now, if I were you, I'd play it smart. And hope this here court takes pity on you.
Fat chance.
No chance otherwise. Right, girls?
Yeah,
that's right.
I'm staying, Luke.
Get on with it.
I reckon it's time we forgot the niceties and voted on it, Jules. Everyone gets a match. A straight match for innocent. A broken match for guilty. There's my word.
Oh, still a bit saddle sore.
Oh, this is one day I definitely don't miss sitting in the governor's chair.
From what you said on the phone, it must have been quite a ride.
It was. Bongo's the worry. Seems determined to resist common sense at every turn.
Oh, probably just a little too much youth and energy.
Let's hope it doesn't land him in too much trouble before he grows out of it.
Well, if Dan's keeping an eye on him, he can't go too far wrong, surely.
Yes, he's certainly got a wonderful way of getting through to people.
He sounds quite a man.
He is. He's,
Your type?
We certainly get along well. The last night didn't help matters much.
Why, what happened?
Oh, stupid of me. All he wanted was to kiss me goodnight, and I pulled away like a 16-year-old on a first date.
Oh, that's not too dramatic.
I was so clumsy about it. It's just this mastectomy thing, you know.
If he's the man you say he is, that won't even come into it. Now, I better be going.
Thanks for dropping in.
You talk to him.
I'll ring him now. Oh, if you help me out of this chair. Next time we're taking the car.
Oh, come on. Oh.
Jeez, I can't stand this. I've got to get to the loo.
Stop panicking. Them bitches can't do nothing. Take my word for it.
I've already done that. Look where it got me.
Jury's in, girls. Even had an impartial count to make sure you got a fair deal.
What's the verdict?
Guilty, of course. What do you reckon?
Jeez, Ray, I didn't
have
to do it.
Shut up, they can't do nothing.
Yeah? Kelly and Jenkins are guilty as charged. Seems to me they ought to have the same punishment they dished out to we won.
Oh, rack off! You and Eggbrain only got a thumping.
Don't remind me. I might add it as an entree.
I say we string the buggers up now.
Oh, no.
It wasn't my idea to kill Wilder. It was Lou.
You didn't try and stop her either. And you gave me a hard time.
Well, if you hang them, you're no better than they are.
I don't reckon so. You see, I'll take a leaf out of Lou's book. Make it look like suicide.
Yeah, we've all seen what a hard time they've been having. Nobody would blame them if they wanted to toss it in, right?
Nobody wouldn't dare.
All those in favour of stringing them up, raise your right arm. Those against?
Grab them!
Your first lurch. Your rope's ready and waiting.
You're missing a great day out there.
Oh, Steve, thanks again for coming in.
Oh, it's all right. It's not every day I get the opportunity to plumb the depths of a women's prison. I hear there's been a bit of excitement.
Yes, Patterson and Windham are back with us.
Yeah, from what I heard, it's cut and dried. Ex-detective or something, isn't it?
Superintendent Bassinger. Poor man, I hope it's not too hard on his family.
Oh, I doubt it. He's a media hero. Yeah,
Windham's swearing black and blue that he isn't, even asked to see the governor about it.
Must be desperate. Yeah. Well, I better be getting on with it.
Right. Oh, Steve, how's the research going?
Oh, all falling into place.
I don't suppose you'll miss Wentworth once all this is over, eh?
Definitely not.
No! Step it up, Lou! No! Get your hands for you!
Ring for gold!
Hey! Should we say goodbye to all the mates?
Yeah, why not?
See, how do you reckon? Pretty sight, eh?
Oh, it's too horrible!
Come on, Lurch! Say that out of your mates!
She's the one that got you swinging!
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the
the roses.